Hey everyone, what's up? In this tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to export your SoundSwitch projects from SoundSwitch Desktop to Engine Lighting. So let's get into it. So in this tutorial video, we're going to be showing you the different ways that you can export your SoundSwitch project from the desktop software to the Engine Lighting application that runs on the Denon DJ hardware. In this particular example, I'm using the Prime 4, but it's the same process if you're using the Prime 2 or Prime Go, or even the players from Denon DJ like the SC5000 or SC6000s. In this example, I'm using the Gigbar Move, and I'll have my micro USB interface connected to the back of the Denon DJ hardware. That interface is then connected via a DMX cable to my lights. So everything runs completely standalone. You have lighting control using the touchscreen, and SoundSwitch will sync up your scripted tracks without the use of a laptop. So here we are in our Engine DJ application. The first thing we want to do is navigate to the preferences, select the library tab, and make sure that the Export via Sync Manager option is turned on. We also want to make sure that we've selected our project location for our SoundSwitch data. We can change this by selecting the change icon and then selecting our SoundSwitch project. In this example, I'm using the default project. So I'll open that default project and make sure that I can see the files. Then I'll click Open. I can now close this. And if I open Sync Manager, select my playlists, and then select to export to my USB drive, I can now export to that drive. SoundSwitch will now pack all of my audio files. And if I switch over to Finder, you can see that there's a SoundSwitch folder with my default SoundSwitch project now placed on my USB drive. I can then take my USB drive out and eject it and connect it to the Prime 4. Another way to export your data is using the SoundSwitch desktop application. Here you can navigate to the file menu, select the export project option, and then you'll be asked to choose whether you want to export all of your venues or just some. In this example, I will just export my Gigbar Move venue, and I will include my exported lighting files. I will then export that and select to save that on my USB drive. Once the export is complete, if we take a look over in Finder, here we can see that my Gigbar Move export project is now saved onto my USB drive. I can then eject the drive and take the drive from the computer and connect it directly to the Prime 4. We want to make sure that our source is selected. Then we want to open Engine Lighting, select our source, and we'll enter Pro mode. We can then open our USB drive and make sure that our Gigbar Move export project is selected and that our Gigbar Move venue is also selected. Now, if I press the red override, as you can see, all of the lights on my Gigbar are now red. I can change the color to blue and even turn on the strobes and increase the strobe rate. If I press play on this track, loaded on the right deck, the light show will start to play back. If I press pause, the light show will pause. And if I pull the record back, the light show will play backwards and forwards. Now, Engine Lighting supports both auto loops, static looks, and scripted tracks. If you have any questions about Engine Lighting or need help getting it set up, please reach out to support@soundswitch.com. You can also reach out in the comment section below or join the user group on Facebook. You can also message us on Instagram Messenger or Facebook Messenger, and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in another video.